Counterpoint, the General Knowledge Music Quiz, chaired by Paul Gambaccini.
Hello. Welcome to a new series of Counterpoint, celebrating the music we love, the music we know but may not love, and the music we don't even know. We've all been missing music performed on stage. Right now, I am on stage, as are three first-class music lovers in our familiar home of the BBC Radio Theatre. But there's no one in the audience. We're about to find out the answer to our version of Bishop Berkeley's classic question: if a tree falls in the forest and there's no one there to hear it, does it make a sound? In our case, it's if a man tells a joke and no one laughs, was it a joke? Let's meet our first lonely-looking trio of competitors.
Hello, I'm John Abramson. I'm a solicitor and I live in Woodford Green, Essex.
Hello, I'm Julie Tate. I'm a retired RE teacher and I'm from Peterborough.
Hello, I'm Martin Warlow and I'm a retired civil servant from Pembrokeshire.
You're all very welcome. The opening round tests your musical general knowledge, and some of your questions will have musical extracts to illustrate them. There are 2 points on offer per question, and if the person asked can't answer correctly, I'll pass it around to the others for 1 bonus point. Good luck, everyone. The first question of the 2020 Counterpoint season is for you, John Abramson. What three-word name has been given to several British orchestras over the years, starting with a post-war body originally formed to record film music, and more recently, an ensemble conducted by John Wilson?
The Film Orchestra?
I'm sorry, that's not it. Martin Warlow.
London Philharmonic Orchestra.
Julie?
I'm sorry, I don't know.
I won't tell John Wilson that none of you knew the London Sinfonia. Julie Tate, for the first musical extract of this series, you're about to hear a work for 4-part choir, which sets the words of a famous poem. For 2 points, I'd like you to tell me the name of the composer and the work.
That's The Lamb by John Taverner.
And that is correct for 2 points. Martin Warlow, between 1998 and 2007, the music of Philip Glass received 3 separate nominations for Best Music at the Academy Awards. Can you name any 2 of the 3 films nominated?
Kernoskatsi? No.
That's not correct?
No, I can't.
And Julie Tate?
Dangerous Liaisons.
I'm sorry, that's not right.
No.
Okay. The 3 were Kundun, The Hours, and Notes on a Scandal. Back to you, John Abramson. For your first musical extract, we turn to an orchestral dance from the French composer Emmanuel Chabrier. What sort of dance is this?
That's a habanera.
That is indeed a habanera, and you get 2 points. Julie Tate, on the 1st of October, 2020, Dame Jenny Murray ended her final episode of Radio 4's Woman's Hour with a recording of the feminist anthem, I Am Woman. It was a poignant moment. The Australian-born singer who performed it had died a few days earlier. Who was that?
Helen Reddy.
And that is right. 2 points. Martin Warlow, music. You're about to hear Kings of Leon in a live performance from 2016. They were guests at a tribute concert hosted by the John F. Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts in Washington. Which successful rock band is being paid homage to here?
I'm running down the road trying to loosen my load. I got 7 women on my mind. For the one on me too.
That's the Eagles.
That's right. The Eagles originally had the hit with the Jackson Browne Glenn Frey song, Take It Easy. John Abramson, 2020 would have marked the 50th anniversary of the Glastonbury Festival, with Paul McCartney, Kendrick Lamar, and Diana Ross among the headline acts that were unable to perform because of the pandemic. Can you tell me under what name the festival was first held on September 19th, 1970?
I'll have a guess. The Somerset Festival?
No, reasonable guess, but not right. Pilton Pop Folk and Blues Festival. Yeah. Everyone's going, oh. Julie Tate, here's music from the Copenhagen-based chamber pop band Choir of Young Believers. They're performing the opening and closing theme of which Nordic noir crime television drama?
Back to the beginning.
The Bridge.
You're right for 2 points. The piece is called Hollow Talk. Martin Warlow, because of his red hair and religious training, which Baroque composer was known as Il Prete Rosso, or the Red Priest?
Vivaldi.
You're right for 2 points. John Abramson, here's music from the movie that became the first foreign language film to win the Oscar for Best Picture at the Academy Awards in February 2020. After you've heard It Is Sunday Morning, I'd simply like you to name the movie.
That's Parasite.
It is Parasite. It is Sunday Morning. Julie Tate, we stay with films for your next question. Which British composer provided the soundtracks to more than a dozen films directed by Ken Loach, including Lady Bird, Lady Bird, Looking for Eric, and the Palme d'Or winning The Wind That Shakes the Barley?
I don't know.
Martin Warlow?
Howard Shaw?
No, I'm afraid not. If we turn to John Abramson.
Michael Nyman.
I won't tell Ken Loach that you didn't know George Fenton. Martin Warlow, finally in this round, some cool jazz for you. Here's Miles Davis's interpretation of a show tune, which I'd like you to identify, along with the musical it's associated with.
I think that's Surrey with the Fringe on top from Oklahoma.
You've got both points. Congratulations. So let's check the scores after the opening round. And we have, with 4 points, John Abramson. And in a tie with 6 points, Julie Tate and Martin Warlow. Because you pick subjects for the next round in the order of your scores in the first, we have to break the tie. I'm going to give you the titles in English of the individual sections in an orchestral suite. The first of you to give me the correct title of the piece will win the tiebreak. Interrupt as soon as you think you know, but beware, because if you get it wrong, I'll continue reading the list for your opponent's benefit. Here goes. Morning. Usher's Death. Anitra's Dance.
Peer Gynt.
Yes, that is correct. The Peer Gynt Suite No. 1 by Edvard Grieg. And so, Martin, you win that particular round, meaning you get the first choice of categories. I'm about to give them five categories to pick from. They have no prior warning of the choices and have had no chance to prepare. So here are today's categories. Beethoven symphonies, to sleep, to dream. The Bible and popular music. The devil has all the best tunes. And 21st century folk music. Martin Warlow, you have the first choice. What would you like?
I'll try Beethoven, please.
And Julie Tate, what would you like?
21st century folk music, please.
Leaving three for John, and they are To Sleep, To Dream, The Bible and Popular Music, and The Devil Has All the Best Tunes.
I'll go with The Devil.
And if you don't do well, you may. John Abramson, here come your questions on The Devil Has All the Best Tunes. Sympathy for the Devil is the opening track on the 1968 album Beggar's Banquet by which British rock band?
The Rolling Stones.
Correct. Music. Let's pay tribute to a singer-songwriter and pioneer of the Southern rock movement who died in July 2020. After we've heard Charlie Daniels and his band, I'd like you to give me the title of this song.
The devil opened up his case and he said, I'll start this show. And fire flew from his fingertips as he rosined up his bow. And he pulled the bow across the strings and it made an evil hiss. And then a band of demons joined in and it sounded something like this.
I don't know, but I'll guess. The Devil's Trill?
Well, you were correct to include Devil in the title, but in this case, the Devil went down to Georgia.
Yes.
The Devil's Chuckle is the nickname for the 13th of 24 caprices for solo violin by which Italian composer?
Paganini.
Yes. Here's a musical composition written by Christoph Komeda for a psychological horror film directed by Roman Polanski in 1968. Can you identify this movie?
Rosemary's Baby.
That was Rosemary's Baby. We heard Rosemary's Lullaby. Staying in the 60s, which worldwide hit of 1967 by the Jimi Hendrix Experience includes the so-called Devil's Chord or tritone played by Hendrix at the start of the song?
I don't know.
Okay. Purple Haze. In popular music, the Devil's... And you know that one.
I know that.
In popular music, the Devil's Tritone has also been heavily used by Black Sabbath and is employed, more surprisingly, in The Girl from Ipanema. Here comes more music. The prelude to an opera where you find love, madness, and dealings with the devil. The story is taken from a set of 18th century paintings by English artist William Hogarth. 2 points are yours if you name this work along with its composer.
Rake's Progress by Stravinsky.
That's right. You get both points. For your final question in this round, I'd like you to name the Welsh rock band led by Kelly Jones, who released the singles Devil in 2005 and Don't Let the Devil Take Another Day in 2019.
A Welsh band. I don't know. Texas?
I'm sorry, it's Stereophonics.
Oh, yes.
And so, in that round, John Abramson, you have scored 8 points. We now move on to 21st century folk music and Julie Tate. What is the name of the Swedish folk duo that consists of the sisters Johanna and Clara Söderberg?
Larkin Poe.
I'm sorry, it's first aid kit. Do you feel like you need first aid?
Yes.
Music now from two more sisters, the British group The Unthanks, led by Becky and Rachel Unthank. In 2019, they provided the soundtrack for a reboot of a classic children's television series, which had originally starred John Pertwee. After you've heard them, I'd like you to name that series.
Oh, the sun shines bright, and the corn grows high, and the crows are gathering in the sky, and the scarecrow sees and the scarecrow knows how to see. Change and the seasons roll.
Wurzel Gummidge.
That is correct. Mackenzie Crook played the lead role. Who's the presenter of Radio 2's regular Wednesday night folk show, which explores contemporary folk music as well as featuring interviews and live sessions?
Stuart McConey.
Oh, I'm sorry. And they both will have a laugh at this because the answer is Mark Radcliffe. They are partners on a favorite six music show. Mark Radcliffe also hosts the BBC's Folk Awards. At the 2019 ceremony, Senegal's Sekou Keita secured a couple of honors, including Best Musician and Best Duo, for his collaboration with the Welsh harpist Catrin Finch. Here's the pair now, Keita playing the kora and Finch the harp, with their interpretation of which famous work by Bach?
G-string.
I'm sorry, the Goldberg Variations. Cello and fiddle player Rachel McShane was the only female member of which successful 11-piece band, which formed in 2004?
Bellowhead.
That is right. Alas, these great advocates for Morris dancing disbanded in 2016. Your final music extract in this round features Kitty McFarlane from Somerset, who occasionally presents Radio 4's Tweet of the Day. Her music often includes her own recordings of nature. Listen carefully to this track from her 2018 album, Namer of Clouds. Can you identify the congregation of birds providing accompaniment here?
We stop and let the sky take hold of our breath as the last of the evening light flees to the west.
Is it a kittiwake?
I'm sorry, it's starlings. Here's your final question. During the global pandemic, which American pop superstar took the opportunity during quarantine to write the folk-influenced album Folklore, released in July 2020?
Taylor Swift.
That is correct, it was Taylor Swift. And in that round, Julie Tate, you scored 6 points. And now, Martin Warlow, Beethoven Symphonies. We mark this 250th anniversary year of Beethoven's birth with a round on his symphonies. Firstly, which symphony was originally called Bonaparte?
The Eroica.
That's right. He removed the title when Napoleon proclaimed himself emperor. This later Beethoven symphony also has a link with the Bonaparte family. Please tell me what it's called.
Is it Wellington's Victory?
That's right. Wellington's Victory, also known as the Battle Symphony. In 1913, the conductor Arthur Nikisch made one of the earliest recordings of Beethoven's Fifth Symphony. Which famous orchestra did Nikisch conduct on that recording?
The RPO.
I'm sorry, it was the Berlin Philharmonic. Nikisch was principal conductor there from 1895 to 1922. Here's a movement from Beethoven's Pastoral Symphony. The movement is usually known in English by what title?
Is it by the brook?
That's right, the scene by the brook. The Allegretto movement of which of the Beethoven symphonies was encored at the first performance given in Vienna in 1813?
Seventh?
That's right, Symphony number 7. Now, more music. A question to follow. Although it was first performed in Vienna, it was a British musical institution that commissioned what turned out to be Beethoven's mighty Ninth Symphony. Which institution?
The Halle?
It was the Royal Philharmonic Society, which also sent him £100 during his final illness to be applied to his comforts and necessities. And finally, which famous name in British music, the first director of the Royal College of Music, published an acclaimed study of the Beethoven symphonies in 1896?
Henry Wood?
Sir George Grove, the original editor of the famous Dictionary of Music and Musicians. And so, Martin Warlow, you scored 8 points in that round. And that means that our totals going into the final round... It's so close. John Abramson and Julie Tate both have 12 points, and Martin Warlow has 14 points. For this year's series, we've changed the rules of the last round. Things can still change quickly for our contestants. I'll ask each of them in turn as many questions as they can answer within the space of a minute. A correct answer wins them 1 point, with nothing deducted for a wrong answer. There are no bonuses. We start alphabetically with John Abramson. Which Austrian composer is known as the father of the symphony?
Haydn.
Yes. Who regularly presents Radio 3's Composer of the Week?
Donald MacLeod.
Yes. What song was the first British number one for Elvis Presley?
Love Me Tender.
All Shook Up. The conclusion to which 1874 symphonic poem by Saint-Saëns depicts a cock crowing?
The Carnival of the Animals.
No, Danse Macabre. Which member of the Rat Pack lost his left eye as a result of a car accident in the 1950s?
Sammy Davis Jr.
Correct. In a letter to his father in 1777, what did Mozart refer to as the king of instruments?
The violin.
No, the organ. Who wrote the music of the 1919 ballet, known in English as the Three-Cornered Hat?
Manuel de Falla.
Yes. Which British-born composer's new work, Tuxedo, Vasco da Gama, opened the series of live concerts in the 2020 proms?
I don't know.
Hannah Kendall. In 1981, Ennio Morricone's composition, Chimai, was used as the theme to which BBC Wales drama serial?
Ooh, I don't know. Possibly.
The Life and Times... That throwback to the Beethoven Symphony round signals the end of the 1 minute. And so, John Abramson, you have got 4 points in that round. Julie Tate, your minute begins now. Which hymn is the anthem of the Women's Institute?
Jerusalem.
Yes. Jessica Ellen Cornish is better known by which stage name?
Pass.
Jesse J. The musician Julian Bream, who died in 2020, was particularly known for playing which instrument?
Guitar.
Yes. Edwin Starr's 1970 hit song War was written as a protest against which war?
The Vietnam War.
That's correct. Rick Ocasek was the lead singer of which group formed in 1976?
Pass.
The Cars. Handel's Water Music was commissioned by which king?
George III.
No, George I. Hello, Little Girl, and Ever After are songs written by Stephen Sondheim for which musical?
Follies.
Into the Woods. The BBC reality TV show The Search, which began in September 2020, was devised by which all-girl group?
Pass.
Little Mix. Courting the Squall is the debut solo album by which British singer?
Pass.
Guy Garvey. The singer and guitarist, Patty C. Alpha. And that ends that minute. And so, Julie Tate, you have scored 3 points in that round. Martin Warlow, your minute begins now. Who composed the operas Nixon in China and Dr. Atomic?
John Adams.
Yes. Which Beatle was the executive producer of Monty Python's Life of Brian?
George Harrison.
Yes. How many black keys does a standard piano have?
36.
Correct. In which German city was Johannes Brahms born?
Hamburg.
Correct. What is the pseudonym of the American singer-songwriter Karen Michelle Johnston?
Pass.
Michelle Schacht. How would you play the musical instrument known as a theremin?
With your hands against an electronic sound wave.
Correct. Bruce Springsteen's 2016 autobiography shares its title with which of his albums?
Born to Run.
You're right. Straight, No Chaser is a 1967 album by which jazz pianist?
Oscar Peterson.
Thelonious Monk. The Windmills of Your Mind won an Academy Award for its use in which 1968 film?
Thomas Crown Affair.
You are correct. You have scored 7 points, which means at the end of this first heat of Counterpoint 2020, the final scores are third with 15 points, Julie Tate, runner-up with 16 points, John Abramson, and our winner with 21 points, Martin Warlow. Well done, Martin Warlow. It means you'll be back for the semifinals in the new year. And well done, the other two of you. You gave us such an entertaining contest to kick off the new series. So close. Remember, if you missed the title or the details of any of the music we've played in today's quiz, you can always see a full list of extracts on our pages on the Radio 4 website. Until next time, from everyone here, goodbye.